LT3 Raptor is being unleashed. We are in the final days of our beta program, where our early adopter users got the software out in the real world and measured over 170,000 actual laser measured projects. With all of the valuable feedback that we've received, we believe this software is now feature complete and ready for everyone. We have a brand new rebuild of the template intelligence engine, dozens of new usability features, and a brand new web companion service in LPI Cloud. We don't have time to show you everything, but in this video, we're going to demo several of our favorite new features. The first time you launch the new application, you're going to be guided through the setup with a setup wizard. We can see on the screen, it's going to tell us what we're about to do. First thing we're going to change is the unit of measure. Much of the world, we'd set this to millimeters. Here in North America, I typically work in inches and fractions, and I set the denominator to 1/16. We'll go ahead and click next. We have multiple screen layouts available. In these presets, if you have been using the LT1 app for years, you may prefer what closest resembles the classic LT1 application. I recommend the LT3 layout. The biggest single reason for this is as you're learning the software, if you're following along with our training videos, this will match everything that we're gonna do in training videos and in the user manual. You can select any of the layout you'd like, and you can always come back and modify for your preferences. Let's go ahead and hit next. One of the important things you want to do is set up the common save settings. So the biggest one I want to talk about is our app output folder. I just click in here and I pick the folder that I typically use. I have a template files folder in documents. I'll select that. Now, every time I save my DXF files and my PDF files for paperwork, it's always going to go to that folder, and it'll follow the naming convention of a job reference, like a job number, and the job name. I like having subfolders on, and anytime I revise a drawing and spit out new DXFs and paperwork, I don't want to merge a copy. I typically like to replace the old document with brand new fresh files. Let's go to next. We also have several sync settings. We'll go into a little bit more detail later, but for the most part, we recommend recommended settings on all of these. You can pick, for example, how far back you want to download all the content from. Again, recommended settings will be best for the vast majority of users. I'll click finish. Here we are in our new home screen. This layout gives you more information and is easier to navigate. Along the left side, we have our new job. We can sync across the top. We can search by job number or name. We have filters for our job. And this button will turn on and off our new knowledge hub. This will have links to training videos and other notices from LPI. Home screen has more information at your fingertips. We have dramatically improved the way jobs synchronize between all the computers within your company. We've prioritized uploading the job with its photos before downloading jobs you may not need at that moment in time. When we look at the home screen, you'll notice that several of these jobs are grayed out. This is because LT3 Raptor is using what we call a job snapshot, which is just the minimum information to fill out this screen. Once I click on the job, it downloads a compressed version of the job. It's a complete package so we can open and start working. Let's talk about autosave. While it's rare that you use it, when you need it, you really need it. And if you've ever had to restore something on your first measure page after editing five other pages, let's just say that you had to get creative to solve that problem. When we build any new feature, we ask ourselves how to make it better. So in LT3 Raptor, we're excited to show you a per page autosave. come up to your edit menu, go to restore page from backup. By default, every single minute, LT3 saves your drawing. So you can see a complete history. And again, this is per page. If the differences are subtle and hard to find, check the show drawing differences and it will highlight every geometry that's changed on that drawing. This is how you see a minute by minute history of every template page. Many legacy LT users can recall how much time can be wasted hunting for tiny little lines that keep you from figuring out your final square footage. The template intelligence engine in LT3 Raptor has been entirely rebuilt and is more powerful than ever. One of the important ways that we use template intelligence is with job check. Think of job check as a spell checker for your geometry. It's going to check and make sure we've got complete closed shapes, which is needed before we proceed on to other steps such as CNC saw page or create stone tags. Let's take a look. On this page, we see up at the top an error symbol that there's an issue found. All I need to do is click on the job check, and we see this panel open up. We can easily turn on or off our contiguous breaks. In most cases, I'm just going to click on the error or the issue that needs to be fixed. This nice visual shows us what needs to be corrected, and it's animating the fix on and off. If there is more than one possible fix, we'd pick the appropriate fix here. In most cases, all I need to do is hit fix now. Just like that, our drawing check is complete. This makes it faster than ever to finish your drawing thanks to job check with fixes. LT3 Raptor now has a ton of quality of life improvements that legacy users will recall from the original app. One of these that I used to use regularly was the ability to select elements by color in order to edit or move in my drawing page. Let's take a look at this. In the multi-tool, I can come up and select by my edge style. In this case, I'm just gonna click my splash and erase with just a couple clicks. Multi-tool has a few other improvements that make it easy to edit and move all your geometries. Another feature that's been requested by many users is to scale a drawing. Let's say we've imported a cutout file that originates in millimeters and we need to convert to inches. It's really simple. On our screen, we can see I've got a sync cutout file and it's just way too large for my unit of measure. We'll go to drop in, scale, and in our command bar, I just pick millimeters to inches, hit update, I'll hit best fit, and we can now see that this is the correct size. It couldn't be easier to scale. We are proud to have LPI lasers in operation all over the world. We've added support for many languages that can update the entire LT3 Raptor interface. First, it's important that you download the language pack in Windows. So I'll go into Settings, Time and Language, and download the appropriate language pack. We suggest, if possible, doing this before you update to this build of LT3 Raptor. Go into LT3 application settings. First, you'll notice everything is really well organized. In general, pick the language you like to see, LT3 Raptor will restart, and you'll see all your buttons are in your language. LT3 Raptor is now multilingual. With the wide variety of CNC machinery out there, at least a few of them have unusual CAD requirements. With that in mind, we've added many new DXF export options, allowing for additional workflows that were not available in beta. One of my personal favorite export options will export all connected geometries with the same edge style as a joined polyline. Let's take a quick look at this kitchen if we open in AutoCAD. And you'll notice that all of these edges are already joined and will be ready for toolpathing. This and many other export options will save you time when prepping your drawings for programming. Many of you have been asking for more control over shop sheet layouts. We have listened. In your export settings, you can see there are options for different paper sizes and a number of different options for pre-built shop sheet PDFs with varying levels of job information and layout alternatives. Just pick what works best for your team. While we're in this screen, I'll change the manifest to detailed. This setting will print additional pages, but I want you to check this out. If I go into the job details and material, I can add the number of supports needed for a large overhang, and this will print out for our installers. Let's take a look at this new detailed manifest. No more splash, sinks, or supports will be left behind at the shop. With StoneTag, you can instantly print production labels for your shop. It's the fastest way to track your tops. With a QR code, you can scan any tag and see the entire job, including template photos. StoneTag is possible thanks to template intelligence, the cornerstone of LT3 Raptor. And because of this tight integration, we are now offering StoneTag with all standard licenses at no additional subscription cost. All you need is the physical printer, the labels, and the ink. We want every single one of you to be able to have the power of tracking your tops. LPI Cloud is the new name for what was templater.com. It's still your online management hub where you can view the latest version of every project and keep your entire company account settings all under control anywhere you have an internet connection. This web-based interface has been rebuilt where your job list copies the LT3 Raptor home screen, and it's got a host of new features. This new design allows you to easily access LPI Cloud on your mobile device, so you can view drawings, job details, and more. You can now view any job that was measured and uploaded by your team on the device that fits in your pocket. We have simplified the types of accounts that are available to you, so that managing your users is easy and gives you more control over who does what. Let's add a new user by going to team members and then invite user. We see this new user begins as a default account. This means they can look around, but they can't edit any jobs yet. Let's change them to a standard user. Now they can edit jobs and do the design work. A limited user is someone that would have limited visibility of jobs unless they create the job or a job is assigned to them. This is often used for template subcontractors or anyone on your team that you want to have focused on just their assigned work. An admin can change the settings across the LPI Cloud account, including edge style settings and customer agreements. If you need an account that does not need to do templates, review drawings, or export, then use the accounting special role to manage payments without needing to pay for an LPI license. With the new user license types, you have more flexibility within LPI Cloud. We also have company-wide managed account settings. Have you ever had a user change an export setting just because? Now you have the ability to control export settings for the entire team. In any export settings panel, you'll notice there's a checkbox where you can lock out the options in the LT3 Raptor software. This will keep everyone exporting the same files to your standards. With LPI Cloud managed settings, your entire team will be exporting the same type of files. With these and many other improvements, we know that compared to the classic app, we are now feature complete. However, it's important to know that we are just getting started. At LPI, we have big things planned for this year and beyond. With this evolution of our software being released, as well as the end of our beta program, and the official start of LT3 Raptor, we're excited to have you join so many others who are making the transition to this incredible new platform. Contact our team to request more information on pricing and any special offers. You also can visit lt3raptor.com to learn more about how LT3 Raptor will improve efficiency in your business. Thank you.